Welcome to the 2021, or actually 2022, Manitou Days Grand Parade celebrating Bears Together. Brought to you by White Bear Events. We're so happy to be back with you tonight after a summer off. Thank you for joining the best summer parade in Minnesota. Local businesses and organizations, clowns, and many great musical groups are on hand and eager to get the show started. But first, representatives including local veterans from the American Legion and VFW are here presenting our nation's colors. And we ask for everyone here at the parade to stand as these important groups pass by.
Of course, we have some vintage Civil War troops marching past here in their vintage outfits. The POW, MIA. As well. We also have, go ahead there, Joe.
Oh, I was going to say, we thank everyone who's joining us from home today to watch this. I'm your one of your hosts, Joe Cullen. I'm joined today by Frank Watson, who's a local meteorologist. We'll be here with you for the duration of the Manitou Days Parade, coming to you from downtown White Bear Lake.
City Council just going by here. We're just kind of getting started here. And Joe, I just want to correct you. We're not Bears Together this year. We're 100 years of water skiing.
Oh, okay.
That was just handed by Bill Weigel.
So and as I mentioned too, we're also I believe in 2022. I think I had it written down here. It was 2021. I'm just a year off.
The fire department is coming by now. The captain, and of course the ambulances that serve the greater White Bear area here as well. We just got a new pumper truck here in White Bear to able to go up to 5 stories now.
Okay. And I know on Suburban Community Channels, our government channel, there's a show that the White Bear Lake Fire Department produces along with the White Bear Lake Police Department called Lake Area Beat.
Yeah, you can catch that on the local channel here as well.
Yep.
One thing about Joe, Joe is a veteran of SEC. He worked there for 20 years, so you may recognize his voice.
Yep, I was joking before I came today that I was making my triumphant return to Suburban Community Channels and the cable television airwaves. That's right, I worked here for 20 years, so I know pretty much most of the crew working here tonight, but I still work in the area and happy to be back to be involved in the parade tonight.
Yeah, usually it's J.P. Barone and somebody else.
Okay.
But, JP is taking the year off, but you will see him in the parade.
Yeah, I was going to say, I saw him here beforehand. I know he's very active in the community. And I actually know him from doing some work with Lakeshore Players Theater.
Right.
We've done some radio dramas over the years. Radio players, and that's kind of put on hold a little bit with the pandemic, but I'm sure he's still quite busy in the community.
Yeah, he's a retired assistant attorney general. Mm. So sometimes I'll just see him walking around town, usually with his grandkids, coming out of Grandma's Bakery, you know, kids are.
And of course he's married to Victoria Reinhardt, who's a Ramsey County Commissioner, so.
Right, and she'll be marching past here a little bit later in the parade as well.
Great. Looks like we have the Lino Lakes Fire Department. Always nice to see other surrounding communities joining us for the parade.
Hugo Fire Department as well.
Our friendly neighbors to the north. So as I mentioned, you're a local meteorologist, so hopefully we can thank you for the beautiful weather we have tonight.
Yeah, every once in a while we'll get like a little brief sprinkle in years past, but there's not a cloud in the sky tonight. It's a beautiful night out. It's not too hot, not too cold, and There's a nice breeze kind of just kind of coming through here a little bit.
Well, I know it's supposed to be really warm by Sunday, so glad that we have some good temps for tonight.
Right, the jet stream is really opening up from the southwest over the weekend here. And we're going to be well into the 90s. But you know, it's summer, and this is what Minnesota is all about. Everybody here at the parade is already in their summer best.
And we do have a nice-sized crowd here. They were gathering early, getting their spots for blocks around here. So nice to see everybody coming out for this. I think especially with cancellation of a lot of events over the last couple of years, I think people are excited to kind of have some of these favorites back again.
Yep. Many of the little kids here with bags to catch candy as it's being thrown to them. Every once in a while, Joe, we'll get one that reaches the deck here. So.
It's one of the benefits.
You might have to fight me for something. Here's the Grand Marshals. This year's Grand Marshals have been water skiing in their blood with 100 years of water skiing. As this year's theme, it's fitting that the two champion skiers lead the Manitou Day's Grand Parade. Siblings Evelyn Chapman Duvall and Paul Chapman, both members of the Minnesota Water Skiing Hall of Fame, are the year's Grand Marshals. The brother and sister duo started skiing around the age of 7. They hold numerous state, regional, and national records and titles and still ski practically every summer day on Bald Eagle Lake. Congratulations to Evelyn and Paul on being selected as the 2022 Grand Marshals of the Manitou Day's Grand Parade.
And as you probably heard, as we're trying to speak over the White Bear Lake High School drum line, they're the musical ambassador for the cities in the White Bear Lake area. They've been featured in many parades and provided entertainment during Super Bowl week in downtown Minneapolis a few years ago. And they're very excited to play for you today.
And passing now is Volunteers of the Year, Carol and Pat McFarland. They have spent a lifetime doing outstanding community service. In addition to Carol's time in the state legislature and school board, she has served numerous organizations, including the Greater White Bear Lake Community Foundation, White Bear Alumni Association, Economic Development Corporation, EDC we call it. Pat, a member of the White Bear Lake Rotary Club, going on 20 years now, was a major player in the YMCA mega renovation project, serving as chair of the capital campaign. He was active in youth hockey and will be involved with Hockey Day Minnesota, which is coming here next this winter, apparently. Congratulations to Carol and Pat on this honor. Well deserved.
Yeah, it's definitely well deserved. Here we have the Manitou Day's Button Design Contest winner. Every year, White Bear Events holds a button design contest for Manitou Days, open to all White Bear area students in grades kindergarten through fifth. This year, over 200 students submitted entries for their interpretation of the 2022 theme, Lake Bears. One design submitted by Wesley Kapisak, hopefully I'm saying that correctly, a fifth grader from Lake Ayers Elementary, quickly rose to the top in the selection progress. He wanted to participate in the contest because he likes art. His button design was inspired by an old ski jump on a lake he used to live by. And in addition to art, Wesley likes playing video games and hanging out with friends. He's also a three-sport athlete, participating in baseball, basketball, and football. Congratulations, Wesley. Your button design featuring a water skiing bear on a ski jump illustrates Lake Bears very well.
And like we mentioned, it's 100 years of water skiing here in White Bear, and if you have some time, come down to the Armory on 4th Street, and you can go in there, and the White Bear Lake Historical Society has this great exhibit on 100 years of water skiing in White Bear. They're open almost every single day, maybe not Monday, but come on down. I think it runs through like July 6th or so, so you have plenty of time. If you're down here for Market Fest on Thursday, that'd be a good time to come on down and check that out.
Oh, that's awesome.
Up here is the White Bear Lake Lions Club. They've been active in the community for 77 years. They like to do good things to help members of our city, and they like to have fun while doing it. This is their famous Precision Lawn Chair Drill Team, performing awesome, inspiring maneuvers throughout the parade route, and they are smart too. When they get tired, they can just sit right down.
That's definitely quite entertaining. Looks like now we have Garlock French Roofing. They've been serving customers for over 90 years with their roofing, siding, and storm restoration needs. They provide high-quality workmanship and products, years of experience, specialized services, and a commitment to every customer. Garlock French's customers know that they aim for excellence on every product they work on and have been providing their customers peace of mind since 1932.
And one thing you need to remember, folks, is May 19th. That is the day we had our big hailstorm move through the White Bear Township, Maplewood, parts of Vadnais, and Shoreview, and Hugo. So if you're going to put a roof claim in, remember May 19th. I get all sorts of calls.
I bet.
Hey, there's a hailstorm that came through. What day was it? May 19th.
May 19th.
Up here is the White Bear Dance Center. They are an award-winning recreational and competitive dance center. Students range in age from 18 months through adult. They specialize in classes in ballet, point, musical theater, tap, jazz, hip-hop, modern, contemporary, lyrical, and arco. Hopefully you all know what that means. The competitive companies have been recognized with awards in title winners, performance awards, costume awards, technique awards, overall high points, and choreograph awards. They have a great technical and performance program with various levels of time, commitments, and experience to fit all dancers' wants and needs. White Bear Dance Center also participates in a custom-created show which performs in Walt Disney World. Florida is expected to begin registration this upcoming fall for the next Florida Adventure. Make sure to check out some of their fall and dance and Disney program options at whitebearddancecenter.com. And let's just take a look at them.
Yeah.
A little gymnastics here too, some of them did.
Yeah. I'm surprised they didn't ask me to do that.
Joe, I think I'm glad they didn't.
Oh.
No offense intended.
No. There's a reason why I don't have a very extensive dancing background, but obviously you can see where is a great place to go if you are interested in that. Very talented.
There's some of the younger ones coming
from
through
the area.
Here.
Yeah.
Just to be fair, Joe, I'm glad they didn't ask me either. So, oh, here comes Joy Erickson leading the Educational Foundation. Joy is a local realtor here in White Bear for Edina Realty. She just opened up a new shop, in fact, on County Road E. She's representing the White Bear Lake Educational Foundation, which supports education in White Bear Lake area schools through awarding classrooms, teaching grants, professional development fellowships for teachers, classroom art grants, bear grants, and student scholarships. The foundation supports district curriculum initiatives, the Angel Fund, what's called the Angel Fund, which was established in the foundation to support students and families of White Bear Lake Area School District so they may attain their basic needs. Celebrating nearly 30 years of enhancing the school district ability to provide excellence in education for all students. The foundation 2022 fundraising efforts include its upcoming 22nd annual golf tournament on June 2nd, Go Bears. And that's probably why Joy is riding around in a golf cart.
Here we have Edina Realty of White Bear Lake, helping you move forward. And here comes Edina Realty, White Bear Lake. Trust your home to our area's number one home selling experts who love this community as much as you do. And since tiny houses are still all the buzz, here's your chance to win a playhouse. Stop into the Edina Realty office at Highway 61 and 4th Street to register for the 14th annual Great Playhouse Giveaway.
Behind them is the Frascetti Catholic Academy, which serves preschool through 8th grade students and is committed to building future leaders through quality curriculum and the Catholic faith. See, what are they handing out here? They have fly swatters.
Ah, nice. Well, looks like they got some candy, too. You get a good haul from them, it looks like.
Yeah, a lot of times, you know, you got to pace yourself when you're throwing candy out, because if you sit here at the beginning, you give all the kids at the beginning, get all the candy, and then you don't have any left for the kids at the end of the parade.
That's true.
You want the kids at the end to like you just as much.
Yeah, otherwise you're going to have some pretty disappointed kids. Here we have the District H Scouts BSA Pack and Troops. Scouting helps the youth in your community reach their full potential by providing them opportunities to grow in the areas of service, character development, leadership, citizen training, and personal fitness. From kindergarten to graduation and beyond, scouts learn new skills, experience new places, and make lifelong friendships. To learn more or to find your local scouting unit, go to scouting.org.
Were you in scouts, Joe?
I actually was, not for terribly long, 2 or 3 years when I was in my youth. How about yourself?
Yep, I was a Cub Scout, then I was a Weeblo, but I was never I never made it to the higher echelon at all.
That's pretty much similar to me. I think I was a Weeblo for a year or so, but my most enduring memory are the Pinewood Derby races.
Oh, yeah, they were always fun.
Yeah.
My car always fell apart going down.
Yeah, first year I didn't do so good. My dad and I kind of purposed to do better the next year, and we did. I don't know that we won at all, but we did considerably better. So.
Yeah, I remember filing down the little nails that they used for axes. Mm. Loaded up with some graphite, trying to make it go real fast, but
yeah.
It just never worked out for me.
Let's see what we have here. Oh, no, just a little scouts.
Yeah, it looks like a support vehicle. Loaded up with candy, probably.
Yeah.
And hopefully some water.
Like we have another band on the way.
Great, I can hear them. It's the Chicago Lakes High School Wildcat Marching Band. It's made up of students in the 7th to 12th grade from Lindstrom, Chicago City, Center City, Schaefer, Taylor's Falls. That's just right north of the Twin Cities here. Typically, the Chicago Lakes Music Department has students performing in public over 100 times throughout the entire year, every year. The Wildcat Marching Band is instructed by Joe Lassie. Let's give them a listen as they come marching around the corner here.
Yeah. think I say this every time I have broadcasted any of the area parades, that I enjoy the marching bands. I was in marching band in my youth, but back in our day, we didn't get to wear short sleeves and shorts. Even in the hot days, we had to wear these polyester uniforms and the whole elaborate thing. So
I thought they might be thick cotton or something.
Yeah, so these guys, they're lucky. But they sound great.
Yep, again. And there's the bear representing 100 Ooh. Years of ski boats in the, well, it's 100 years of water skiing celebration here in White Bear. And that's Sasha the Bear, the big story in the White Bear Press. If you didn't get the White Bear Press, you can go online and read it. You can read all about who made the Sasha the Bear and the story behind it. And if you want to see Sasha, visit the armory and Sasha is there.
That's fun. I think we just quickly there saw some student riders, the Manitou Days Student Riding Contest winners. The White Bear Lake Area Schools team up with the Manitou Days Committee and others to highlight our student riders in grades K through 8 through a riding contest. And again, this year's theme is Lake Bears.
Premier Bank is a local business, as we see on right now. That's Premier Bank, a local business, community bank that prides itself on exceptional products and services and genuine personal relationships. They're located right there on, 3rd Street and Highway 61.
And behind them, we have the Academy for Sciences and Agriculture, a public charter school for grades K through 12 located in Vadnais Heights in Little Canada. They engage learners in academically rigorous, student-centered, hands-on experiences and leadership opportunities within a science, environmental education, and agricultural context.
And it looks like they're passing out some honey. You can also visit them at during Market Fest on Thursday nights from 6 to 9. They have a booth down there telling you all about their school.
Yeah, that's great.
Behind them is some more fitness people, fitness freaks. Flips Gymnastics, home of the Level 10 Team State Champions. They have been serving the White Bear Lake area for over 30 years. Flips offers a variety of programs for boys and girls, preschool, recreational, ninja, and teams. Let's see what they can do. I could do a handstand when I was younger, and that was about it.
I couldn't even do that, so. And of course, I'm sure gymnastics is always popular, but probably renewed interest since this last Summer Olympics when Suni Lee from the St. Paul area won the gold medal in women's gymnastics. So I'm sure many of these youngsters look up to her. I always thought it seems very difficult to do the types of things they do, and especially on the street. Not a very forgiving surface, but they all seem to know what they're doing. So. Well, here we have Manly Gardening. Manly Gardening is your local hometown gardener that provides design, install, and maintenance services in White Bear Lake and the surrounding community. They are certified landscape professionals by the Minnesota Nursery and Landscape Association. They are also proud supporters of the White Bear Lake Schools Career Pathways Program and provide internships and work opportunities for students interested in the green industry.
Coming up now is Preferred Kitchens. They're located right there on Highway 61. If you're headed north, you pass right past them. They're right off of between 2nd and 3rd Street. Preferred Kitchens has been your local remodeler for kitchens, bathrooms, and more for over 30 years. Thanks for supporting the local businesses.
Speaking of locations, as I mentioned, this parade's taking place in downtown White Bear Lake. We're kind of situated, between 3rd and 4th Streets on Banning Avenue.
And here come the area District 36 Republicans. Roger Chamberlain is our current representative, and State Senate Elliot Ingen, he's running for House District 36A. So it's election time, so it's good to get out there and read about these candidates and learn more about them. I believe they also have a booth here in during Market Fest, so you can come down there and you can give some quizzes and see what they think about things. You can give me your opinion as well and what sort of things interest you. Yeah. Everybody's down here at Market Fest, all the major parties. So.
Yep.
If you have a concern, that's a good way to express yourself and meet the candidates up close.
And we thank everyone for joining us for our coverage of the Manitou Days Parade. Once again, I'm Joe Cullen, and my fellow host here today is Frank Watson, local meteorologist. And this next parade entrant is kind of going to make me hungry. I haven't had dinner yet. And here we got Carboni's Pizzeria and Pub. It's the pizza the whole family loves, located at 1350 Highway 96. East in White Bear Lake, locally owned and operated for more than 30 years. Great pizzas, delicious burgers, awesome appetizers, and the best happy hour in White Bear Lake.
Yeah, they're owned by the Boleyn family, and if you're going to come down for fireworks on July 4th, they will be down there serving pizza, so ooh, join them down there. Hey, Joe, do you need a job?
I don't, but I'm curious about what I'm seeing here.
Well, when my daughter was young, the first job she wanted was to be a bus driver. And, well, here is North Star Bus Lines. They rep, they're looking, as you can see by the side of the bus, they're hiring. So if you need a job, text driver to 484848 to apply. So North Star Bus Lines and North Star Bus Lines, our family comes first and our drivers are family first. We're looking for individuals willing to help get students to and from school safely. We'll provide training and we'll pay you to get your CDL Class B with school bus and passenger endorsements. If needed, take advantage of the flexible scheduling, weekly pay up to $24 an hour, and generous sign-on bonus. We're also hiring van drivers, paras, mechanics, North Star Bus Lines, and American Student Transportation has been family-owned and operated since 1963. Remember, text drivers, 484848.
Here we have Bear Boating. They've been operating since 2015 and serve seniors age 60 and up, active duty military, veterans, and the disabled. In 2022, they're scheduling up to 8 guests per trip with up to 3 trips daily, Monday through Friday, in June through August.
Yeah, you'll see them launching right off the VFW down there on the western shore of White Bear Lake. The White Bear Lake Community Foundation is home hotel for the White Bear Country, featuring White Bear Event Center and award-winning Rudy's Red Eye Grill and Rudy's Rooftop. Stop by tonight for dinner or a Rudy Teeny. Also on the fire truck are board members of the Greater White Bear Lake Community Foundation. The mission is to inspire philanthropy and enrich the lives of the communities that share the shores of White Bear Lake.
And up behind them, we have some more great music from the United Marching Band. They include 8th through 12th grade students from all secondary schools in District 622. They are all united into one marching band under the direction of Lori Bernstrom, Aaron Hammerman, John Povelin, Meg Halston, and Colin Hugh.
Behind them is Elevated Beer, Wine, and Spirits, White Bear Lake's destination for the best selection of craft beer in the North Metro. Stop in to the store on 4th Street, right next to Pestle Pizza, or shop online for fast delivery at www.elevatedbws.com.
Now we have the White Bear Youth Football. White Bear Youth Football was established in 1983. They have provided area youth with a fun and affordable program that encourages physical and mental conditioning, fair play, and good sportsmanship while learning the fundamentals of tackle football. Please visit wbyouthfootball.org to learn more.
This character here right behind him is Boogie for Jesus, which is a dance ministry that tries to create an atmosphere wherever they perform. And they are creating it here tonight. Its feature performer and founder is rapper named Lorvin. Through the use of his four characters of the charismatic, the Godinator, the entertainer, and the God Pitbull, he has probably entertained over 3 million people through 200 parades, the Minnesota State Fair, the Shrine Music Festival, along with other events. He takes popular music, cleans up the lyrics, and then gives over 30 songs a great message. For parades, he uses a convertible car with a strobe light. To find out more, go to boogieforjesus.com.
And behind him, we had U.S. Bank White Bear Lake. And employees from their downtown U.S. Bank were handing out candy. And right behind them, things are moving fast. But we have Heidi Gunderson for 36B. Which includes friends to elect Heidi Gunderson to House District 36B. She's running to be your next state representative. Heidi is working to represent residents of White Bear Lake, White Bear Township, Birchwood Village, Gem Lake, and Vadnais Heights. For more information, visit her website at heidiforhouse.org.
Joe, I didn't mean to mess you up.
No, you didn't.
Reading Boogie for Jesus, and I looked up, and I saw the trunk of the van here, and it had U.S., so I thought that was like the last part of Jesus, when it's really U.S. Bank. I didn't mean to slight U.S. Bank.
Like I said, U.S. Bank has employees from their downtown branch handing out candy, and yeah, we got kind of a... Sometimes you have little gaps, and right now we got quite a few moving quickly. And
I was just U.S. Bank today, and I can see Sierra Wehrstad. She's a bank teller. She's also a banker. She hands out loans.
Right now she's handing out candy.
I asked her if she could get me a great rate, but she can't do much, she says, right now.
Oh.
But she says, come on down, and we'll find something for you. Goes Heidi Gunderson, running for state representative. And there she is right there. In the blue. Along mainstay of downtown is the Medicine Chest Pharmacy. It's located right in the heart of downtown White Bear Lake. The store has been in continuous operation since 1930, making it one of the city's oldest retail businesses. The owners and staff are proud to serve the loyal community with top-notch customer service and patient care. Medicine Chest is also the home of all things polar bear, earning the nickname the Polar Bear Store. On the float is a sampling of the concrete statues that can be purchased at the store. Medicine Chest also carries a wide variety of other White Bear Lake merchandise, including apparel, souvenirs, and gifts. Stop by sometime and experience the customer service that sets us apart.
And here we have Bear Care Clinic, Rise Up Health Clinics. The Bear Care Clinic, run by Rise Up Health Clinics, is located in North Campus and provides no-cost health services to children of all ages in the White Bear Lake Area School District. It's open to any child in the district during the school year, and services available include wellness exams, sports physicals, vaccines, illness care, and more. The clinic was founded in 2020 by St. Catherine University nursing faculty. And during the 2021-22 school year, Bear Care provided health care services to nearly 1,500 children. Clinic is staffed by St. Catherine University nursing professors who are committed to improving children's health and education outcomes and are proud to be partners of the district.
Just north of White Bear Lake is Benson Airport, and you can see their float coming up now. Benson Airport The little airport on the hill has been here in White Bear for over 80 years. Home to several local pilots, the airport and its members welcome all to come and experience the adventures of flight. You ever go flying in one of these small planes?
I don't think I have in one that small, no. Have you?
Well, something similar to this, but it had actual wings on it. I have a buddy that's a pilot, and he would take us up every once in a while.
Okay.
We would rent one out and fly around. It was kind of fun.
Oh, yeah, I bet it would be. Yeah.
Get to see the Twin Cities from a different perspective. It's kind of cool.
Yeah. Well,
Benson Airport just located just north of White Bear Lake off of Highway 61.
And I'm guessing this must be Kevin Magnuson for Washington County Attorney.
Let's see here.
Maybe not. He's elsewhere. Well, it does look here like we do have South Shore Trinity Lutheran Church. Their float is George Gifford's 1937 John Deere A tractor in classic John Deere green. South Shore Trinity Lutheran Church is located at 2480 South Shore Boulevard in White Bear Lake and would like to invite all children to this summer's Vacation Bible School. Their program this summer is titled Monumental, Celebrating God's Greatness. Vacation Bible School will be held August 1st through August 5th from 9 a.m. till noon each day. And to register, go to sstwbl.org.
And there's Teacher of the Year for White Bear Lake 2022, May Haley.
And we have the Unlimited Next Level Drill and Dance Performing Arts. They were founded in 2005 under the direction of Mr. Stephen Graham, who passed away in June of 2012. Now this team is under the direction of Ms. Denise Cole.
Talent in you?
Some. I did play alto sax through high school. As mentioned, did marching band, and I enjoy singing, especially karaoke, things like that. I wouldn't say I should quit my day job for it, but I do enjoy doing it. How about yourself?
I have very little musical talent at all.
Unlimited Next Level.
Behind them is San Law. San Law is a personal injury law firm with offices in White Bear Lake and St. Paul. San Law proudly represents injured individuals throughout Minnesota. Looks like he's in a nice vintage Cadillac Eldorado convertible.
That is nice.
And he's passing out t-shirts.
Oh, wow, yeah. He's definitely getting attention with that.
While driving. It's a good arm.
Yeah, not even using a t-shirt cannon like they do at some of the sporting events.
Looks like he's a little help behind him, passing out t-shirts as well. The Uncle Sam hat. The individual there.
Yeah. Again, we thank you so much for choosing to spend the time watching this on SEC On Location. If you're interested in learning more about Suburban Community Channels and some of their programming, obviously tune into the channel or visit their website at sctv.org. Many great programs, programs that they produce. They also they have their live truck out here tonight, which they use to cover parades like this, many school events, graduations, sporting events. I know they'll be covering a lot of great sports, especially come fall. Football games are always one of the more popular things they cover. Here we have Swell Wake Surf. They're your local wake surfing specialists. So we encourage you to check out their website, which unfortunately I don't have here, but I'm assuming you can just Google Swell Wake Surf and you'll get all the information you need if you're interested in doing some wake surfing here in the area.
It's good to have them down here. It's 100 years of celebrating water skiing in White Bear Lake. You can find Swell at Market Fest as well. Mm. They set up on the corner of Banning and Forest Street, and they actually bring this boat down. We have a kind of a land wake surfer here rolling past. There he goes. Do you have any water skiing growing up?
Not really, no. How about you?
Yeah, it took me a while, but I did it, and I really enjoyed it. And I wish somebody would take me out again.
I did see, I noticed, looks like if you are interested in learning more, you can go to swellwake.com. So SWELLWAKE.com, and you'll learn all about them.
Joe, do you ever hear a loud bang when opening or closing your garage door?
I do.
That's sometimes indicating you might need a new spring. And the people you need to call is Twin City Garage Door. For all your business and personal garage door needs, call Twin Cities Garage Door in White Bear Lake.
I actually just had a loud noise about a week or so ago as I was leaving my home, and as the garage door went up, I heard a loud noise. I said, that can't be good, and sure enough, I had to get it fixed.
Yeah, one side goes up, and the other kind of stays behind a little bit, and next thing you know, you're pulling the emergency release.
Yep. Here we have the White Bear Lake Lacrosse Club. I think, though, we also got a look there at the 1945 Willie's Jeep MB. And right behind him is the White Bear Lake Lacrosse Club, the premier youth lacrosse organization for White Bear Lake youth athletes. White Bear Lake Lacrosse strives to promote youth lacrosse for children living within the White Bear Lake area and the surrounding areas as well.
And that's one thing I wish we had when we were young. My daughter played it for a while, and I really enjoyed practicing with her. It was a lot of fun.
Yeah, I always think that, you know, it's so popular now, but yeah, when I was young, especially in the Midwest, you didn't really hear a lot about it. I think I would have enjoyed it because I wasn't quite in football or anything like that, but I think lacrosse I would have enjoyed.
Maple Tree Pediatric Dentistry provides all the gentle encouragement and fun, child-friendly atmosphere that encourages fun for relaxing visits for patients. For if you have a young person who's visiting the dentist for the first time, check them out. Maple Tree Pediatric Dentistry.
And behind them, we have the ever-popular St. Paul Winter Carnival Royal Family. Always a popular staple at any Twin Cities parade.
Have you ever been marked by the Vulcans?
I have, yes.
I never have, so. Which is okay.
Yeah, I think I have. I know, my youth, I probably was. I'm sure they'd be more than happy to oblige if you
That's all right.
want
That's,
them to come up here.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's a good thing they can't hear us. But you'll find these guys, they come down for the our golf on ice, the Merrily Open, and in the middle of winter, that they're out there for that. They're all around town, the metro area here, especially the east side. The Winter Carnival West Wind organization is composed of previous West Wind royal family legend characters, West Wind princess, their princesses, and their royal guards. Prince of the West Wind Zephyrs plays the role of keeping his irresponsible and unstable brothers in place, while the West Wind Princess fosters gentle harmony within the royal family. They are responsible for the bountiful West Wind and bring the big yeehaws to the coolest celebration on Earth. And here, I guess they have several floats. So here comes the West Wind part of them. A few dressed in cowboy hats.
Yeah.
The fishing team is right behind them, close on their tail. Here's the White Bear Lake High School fishing team with Nelson Marine as one of their major sponsors. Tight lines, everyone.
It's another one. I don't think we had a fishing team back in the day in high school. So
yeah, I believe there's like a mountain biking one also.
Yeah, lots of fun options mm-hmm. for students.
And they get to ride a pretty cool looking boat as
yeah.
well.
Yeah, not a bad way to spend your Friday evening. Oh, and we're getting a whole crowd here in the boat.
I gotta admit, I was kind of spoiled growing up. My grandfather lived in Rice Lake, Wisconsin, and he had this old wood boat. It was a Chris Craft, and I thought, Grandpa, you should get one of these really cool fiberglass boats. And he kind of looked at me and laughed. And now when I look back at it, it's like, oh, you're thinking Frank?
Here we have Bear Roofing and Exteriors Incorporated. They're a well-established roofing and exteriors company servicing White Bear Lake and the Twin Cities metro area. With over 20 years of experience, they offer a full range of services tailored to meet the needs of their customers. Estimates and storm inspections are always complimentary and pressure-free.
Behind them is Bear Tracks CAV Shuttle. White Bear Lake will be home to a year-long self-driving vehicle pilot project starting this summer. All are welcome to ride the shuttle. For more information about the project or how to ride, visit BearTracksWBL.com. Now, this is one of those automated shuttles, so there's really no driver. You can see a driver in there, but all he does is just wave his hand and the thing drives itself. It's driverless and electric.
Wow.
And I believe it'll be going down by the YMCA along Orchard in that general area down there. I think I've seen some markings for them, so it'll be interesting to see how that works out. They've lowered the speed limit in that area to 25. So it'll be interesting. Maybe a wave of the future right here.
Yeah. We have the waters of White Bear Lake. Nestled near the Gem Lake and Lakeshore neighborhoods, the Waters is bringing an exceptional senior living experience to White Bear Lake. By combining a sophisticated architectural design with high-quality care and amenities, this luxurious community will be a place you'll be proud to call home. They offer independent living, assisted living, and memory care.
Behind them is the American Cancer Society. Join our family-friendly American Cancer Society fundraising walk at White Bear High School South Campus. This year, we are back on the track on July 29th from 6 p.m. to 11 p.m. for the night of fun as we gather to fight back against cancer. That's a pretty big event there at South Campus.
Yeah. Here we have Senate District 36 DFL. We welcome the Senate District 36 candidates and their supporters.
Yeah. Betty McCollum, Ryan Curran, Susie Strom. There's J.P. Barone. Did we get him? Supporting his wife, Victoria Reinhardt. And there's Betty at the end. There's J.P. right there. And then Betty McCollum right there in the blue. And they are also down at Market Fest as well.
Victoria was in that van that just went by.
Hockey Day Minnesota is going to be here in White Bear Lake in 2023. It's a pretty big event. A lot of the Minnesotan down here in downtown White Bear Lake has been coordinating a lot of this along with the Minnesota Wild. And just at this past Market Fest, some representatives of Minnesota Wild had came down here to check out Market Fest. We're going to have a theme at Market Fest called Hockey Day Minnesota Theme, where we're going to try to get the community more involved in it. So when they play in the winter of 2023, just this next year here, we hope a lot of people will be participating in that as well.
Well, that'll be a great event. Band playing on the back of this float for Hockey Day Minnesota.
They're sponsored by Twin City Orthopedics, and on the back there, we also have the Minnesotan, which is a downtown business here.
Yep.
Let's give them a listen.
Come on, Eileen.
Ever have any desire to drive a Zamboni?
Have I ever driven one?
Yeah, well, any desire?
Oh, desire, sure, yeah, I haven't. That would be fun. I believe on that Zamboni was a group including Zach Halverson, who I think works for KFAN now. And he actually used to do a lot of work with SEC. Here we have the Catalyst Covenant Church in White Bear Lake. They're a new church plant. Catalyst meets at 10 a.m. Sunday mornings at the White Bear Area YMCA. They're a church that strives for connection with each other and with our community over perfection. Or they strive for the connection over perfection. And they'd love to have you come and worship with them. Kind of right behind them, we have a gentleman from Tactical Escape 101 in the black shirt there. It's the Minnesota branch of the family-owned Wisconsin-headquartered amusement company. Ask about their military and first responder discounts. They're proud to be opening a new room at our Maplewood Mall location, the Rattlesnake Saloon, which is an old-fashioned Western adventure.
Behind Tactical is BioLife Plasma Services. That's that big yellow drop that you see in your picture there. BioLife Services is an industrial leader in the collection of high-quality plasma that is processed to life-saving plasma-based therapies. We operate numerous state-of-the-art plasma collections facilities throughout the United States and Europe. The closest is right here in St. Paul. BioLife is committed to safety through our superior service. We strive to ensure the safety of our donors and patients who receive life-saving plasma-based therapeutics.
Here we have the Manitou FC, some soccer players from our local club, again, Manitou FC. Be sure to get a flyer with information on how you can join this talented family of soccer players and develop your game.
And you can hear it. Joe, you're gonna have to help me out here. It looks like the Forest Lake Ranger Marching Band is coming up on us. Of course, Forest Lake is our neighbors just to the north of us. They also have a pretty big parade, which features many marching bands. Forest Lake Marching Band is one of the more popular bands here in the Twin Cities. I believe they go all over the place and play for different parades. Let's listen to the Forest Lake Rangers Marching Band play.
Facebook, and it looks like they have a pretty busy summer ahead of them of different performances, including obviously Manitou Days. They'll be performing in other parades, and as you mentioned, July 4th, there's a 4th of July parade in Forest Lake, so they definitely get around.
Saved by the smartphone.
Here we have Spire Credit Union, and representing Spire Credit Union is Archie, Spire's 1952 Ford pickup truck. Archie is named after Spire's founder, Edgar Archer, and symbolizes the Midwestern values that drive Spire: trust, honesty, integrity, hard work, compassion, and humility. To learn more about Spire and their innovative products and services, visit myspire.com or stop into a branch near you to speak to one of Spire's friendly financial representatives who will be ready to assist you. Looks like they have a dog mascot hanging out in the back.
Behind them is White Bear Meandry. Mead is an ancient fermented honey beverage. Our star ingredient is Minnesota Harvest honey that we blend with many other fresh local ingredients like local strawberries, raspberries, maple syrup, and apples, to name a few. We educate the uninitiated to our new tasting room by sip and story. Come drink like a Viking, drink mead. I think they're located down there on just east of Highway 61 on Connie Road E. Mm. They have an operation out there. Now, I had to look that up when I heard the word mead. And what is mead? It's an alcoholic drink.
I have been there once, and I enjoyed it. I think the gentleman who was walking by, I think is the owner, very knowledgeable, and I didn't know much going in there, and he helps out with good recommendations. Here we have the White Bear Lake Girls Hockey. These girls are a member of the White Bear Lake Area Hockey Association's Girls Hockey Program. The hockey program has opportunities for girls just learning to skate within the clinic program. It has teams from 8 under to 15 under within the association. For more information about the Girls Hockey Program, you can visit WBLHockey.com/girls.
They have a pretty good crew out here.
Yeah.
Nice of the kids to take an evening off and come downtown. Maybe they get bribed with all the candy that they're passing out a little bit.
As we mentioned, you know, hockey obviously popular statewide, especially in this area.
Behind them is the Main Street Association. That's made up of the local downtown White Bear Lake businesses. You can visit their website, Downtown White Bear Lake, and they give you all sorts of information about local downtown businesses. I'm a former board member myself. Oh. They put on all sorts of events. They also, you know, Market Fest being one of the events, they have a Midsummer Night's Dream coming up, Dog Days later on this fall, all sorts of ones. Behind him is White Bear Mitsubishi. Oh, and we just saw Rome Bike. If you have a bike, there's a new bike shop called Rome in downtown Minneapolis. It's just off to my right here at the corner of 3rd and Banning. Definitely want to come down there. They have electric bikes that they're really been promoting quite a bit lately. And they have just regular bikes as well.
Yeah, we can literally see their shop right from where we're at.
There's the owner, John Sheehan, right there. Hey, John. Hey, Bruce, there's a president of Main Street, Bruce. He owns the Olive Oil place here on 4th and Banning. And there goes that group, but you may recognize this bear here. It's the Mitsubishi bear, kind of made famous on all those commercials. Located right down here on Highway 61. Blowing us some kisses. And they're also a sponsor of Market Fest. They bring out the cars that you see passing by here. They have some electric ones, they bring it down, and some of their latest models as well.
I believe we had a Market Fest last night.
Mm-hmm. And of course, it's we're celebrating 100 years of water skiing on White Bear Lake. Coming down the street here, you just saw a second ago, it's kind of in the foreground there, is the water skiers and the ski otters. They perform on Goose Lake there, just south of County Road E. They put on shows on Sundays. Joe, you want to read that one?
Sure. They're celebrating not only 27 years of the free ski shows in White Bear Lake, they're also celebrating 100 years of water skiing. Every Sunday during the summer, ski otters perform free water ski shows for the community of White Bear Lake. It's a fully scripted, narrated, and choreographed story brought to life on the water. This year, they'll bring you Once Upon an Otter. Get ready to have your favorite fairy tales come to life on the water as Grandpa reads you some of the classic bedtime stories. Whether your favorite character is Snow White, Cinderella, or the Big Bad Wolf, you'll get a chance to be part of the tale like never before. The stories will be just as you remembered. That is just as long as Grandpa reads from his trusted storybook. Without his book, Grandpa sometimes gets those stories mixed up. If that happens, it's almost certain that anything can happen both on and off the water. See firsthand that skiing is believing.
Yeah, I wanted you to read that so I could check out the pyramid they were making. That's the only reason. Yeah, they perform on Sundays on Goose Lake. You can go online, check out their schedule so you can see a show. There's no cost. Bring your family down there if you have kids. I know they will be amazed on some of the talents that these skiers have.
We're kind of getting towards the end here, but just do want to remind folks out there, we've mentioned Market Fest a number of times. It's a family-friendly summer festival in beautiful downtown White Bear Lake. Just started last night, and it'll be every Thursday now until July 28th from 6 to 9 p.m., rain or shine. They have a lot of theme weeks. Next week is the 23rd, is White Bear Lake History Night. After that, you have such things as Biz Kids, Biz Seniors Night, and July 14th is White Bear Hockey Night. So go to marketfestwbl.com to get more information on that.
And you'll see me down there, too. I wear a yellow vest. I help the the vendors get in and out, just help with some crowd issues if you're lost.
I was hoping you were going to say that you wear some kind of mascot outfit.
No.
No?
Yeah, we used to just wear t-shirts, but nobody listened to us. Then we put vests on. Now people actually listen to us.
A little more official.
Yeah. If you lost something, they know who to come to now.
All right. Well, on behalf of White Bear Events, we hope you enjoyed the 2022 Manitou Days Grand Parade. 100 years of water skiing is our theme today. As you collect your belongings and hopefully a bag of candy or two, we wish to acknowledge the following businesses who provided both financial and in-kind support to the Manitou Days Grand Parade, including Boy Scout Troop 434, Ken Galloway, Dick Mumblow, Paul the Plumber, Suburban Community Channels, Bill Weigel Signs, City of White Bear Lake, White Bear Lake Public Works, and the White Bear Lake Police and Reserves. And last, but certainly not least, a big thank you to our parade volunteers. We want to thank you, Frank Watson, for giving up your time tonight to help us broadcast the parade.
And thank you, Joe, as well. And I also want to thank the staff of SEC, the camera operators, the audio guys, David, the director, Arlen. Thank you for having me back another year, and I wish I caught everybody else's name, but I want to thank them for coming out and making us look better than I really am.
Yeah, thanks so much for tuning in. If you want to catch this program in its entirety, if you joined us halfway through, make sure you go to sctv.org. You can find Times the Lair and all sorts of other great information. So once again, from the 2022 Manitou Days Grand Parade, thanks for joining us, and hope to see you out at Market Fest.
Good night.